The JFK assassination, one of the most tragic events in American history. On a warm Friday afternoon, November 22nd of 1963, in Dealey Plaza of Dallas, Texas, John F. Kennedy was shot and killed while parading through the city. Questions about this event remain unanswered to this day. Who really killed JFK? Was it Lee Harvey Oswald? Was he acting in coordination with the Kremlin in Moscow? Where does Jack Ruby fit into the puzzle? Was JFK even the real target? All of these questions will be answered in this one-part documentary about John F. Kennedy and the events surrounding his assassination. Young Money Brick Squad's unique and in-depth research has provided evidence that suggests what happened on that warm yet fateful afternoon.
Where were you on the day of the JFK assassination?
I was sitting in my senior, some class, I don't know what it was. It was the afternoon, an announcement came on that JFK had been assassinated or shot, that he wasn't dead yet.
How old were you at that point?
I was about 35. Took me a while to get through high school. But I made it here to Harvard.
Did you cry?
I wept for 3 days along with the country.
What made you want to become a JFK expert?
I had some thoughts that perhaps there was someone else behind the assassination.
What have you been doing for the past 35 years?
Researching and trying to find out the actual facts of the assassination.
What has your research indicated?
I think it had something to do with Jackie. Not sure if she was behind it. It could have been that Lee Harvey Oswald was, I did find out he was sending her stalking Jackie and had sent her some love letters. He may have been obsessed with her. But it could have been that Jackie was upset with JFK because she had found out certain things about his romancing other women.
So do you think that Oswald was trying to kill Jackie instead of...
Could have been, yeah.
Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor.
The response of the American people was outrageous. The hearts of mothers, fathers, sons, daughters, grandmothers, grandfathers, aunts, uncles, cousins, and pets were all broken by the loss of such a prominent leader. The nation demanded answers, and they thought they would get them when 3 days later, tragedy struck again.
Madness and hate erupt anew in Dallas. As President Kennedy's accused assassin is shot down himself during a jail transfer. There's an ominous symbol in Lee Harvey Oswald's murder weapon as he is taken to the city jail basement where an armored car is to move him to a maximum security cell. Oswald walks his last mile. His assailant moves in from the right.
There is Lee Oswald. He's been shot. He's been shot. Lee Oswald has been shot.
Now, from another camera, the motion is slowed. The murderer moves in, and here is the shame of all America as Jack Rubenstein takes the law unto himself. The dying Oswald is rushed to the same hospital where President Kennedy died. Doctors work to save his life. But 48 hours and 7 minutes after the president's death, his accused slayer is dead.
After an in-depth investigation by Young Money Break Squad, it was determined from Jack Ruby's interview that it was never his intention to kill Lee Harvey, and he never even fired his weapon.
Listen, you son of a bitch. You're gonna talk, or I'll slit your throat.
I didn't do anything.
It's bullshit! We saw you!
I did not kill him. I had tongs.
Why the hell? Why would you have a pair of tongs?
I'm trying to save him.
With the pair of tongs?
Ow! Shit.
Bullshit!
Who then organized for Lee Harvey to kill John F. Kennedy? Documents suggest that Lee Harvey's actual target was Jackie Kennedy. Lee Harvey, in fact, missed his shot. After Jackie Kennedy realized that she was the actual target of Lee Harvey Oswald, she was the one that killed him. Jack Ruby simply had a pair of plastic cooking tongs that he planned to use in helping free Lee Harvey. This newly discovered picture shows an incognito Jackie Kennedy firing the fateful shot that killed Lee Harvey Oswald. The tables had turned. Luckily for Jackie Kennedy, she was able to bribe the Dallas Police Department into pinning the murder on Jack Ruby.
This is Walter Cronkite in our newsroom. And there has been an attempt, as perhaps you know now, on the life of President Kennedy. He was wounded in an automobile driving from Dallas Airport into downtown Dallas, along with Governor Connally of Texas. They've been taken to Parkland Hospital there, where their condition is as yet unknown. We have not been told their condition. At Dallas, in the downtown hotel room, a group had been gathered to hear President Kennedy when he was waiting his arrival. Let's switch down there now, where Eddie Barker of KRLD is on the air.
As you can imagine, there are many stories that are coming in now as to the actual condition of the president. One is that he is dead. This cannot be confirmed. Another is that Governor Connally is in the operating room. This we have not confirmed.